Lewis Hine was an American sociologist and photographer from Wisconsin who taught in New York City. There, he always encouraged his students to use photography as an educational medium. Hine used his camera for social reform. He first began with photographing Ellis Island with his class, but became the photographer for the National Child Labor Committee, where he would secretly begin documenting living and working conditions of these child workers. His photos often have a dark background with illuminated subjects, making them stand out in the big, messy rooms. In this photo, you can see the child laborers that are working on glasswork in Indiana. Lewis Hine was able to accomplish what many photographers could not. He was able to secretly document living conditions of child workers to show how much they were neglected and overworked at such a young age. This photo, being so far away, contains so many children who are obviously filthy from work. The lighting that Lewis Hine uses illuminates their faces, which contrasts against the dirt, their clothes, and the dark background, creating a shocking effect to the photograph. The explanatory photos that Lewis Hine took of the Breaker Boys in Pennsylvania are so iconic that you might even remember seeing them in history textbooks. His photos are so impactful for their gritty texture, artistic elements, and shocking content. Around this time, there were over 2 million children under the age of 15 that were working industrial jobs in the U.S. The Breaker Boys had one of the most dangerous jobs. The machinery was heavy, sharp, and threatening, especially for young boys. While photographing living conditions, Lewis Hine often took photos of children as descriptive and explanatory photographs, sharing their stories with the world. This young girl, Cora Lee Griffin, was from Whitnall, North Carolina, and only 12 years old. That is not old enough for a job, however, she wanted to get an education, having only gone to school until grade 6. So, she worked full-time as a spinner in a cotton mill, making 48 cents a day. These photos are capable of telling a story on their own. The strong lighting and stern looks on the children's faces makes them look worn, tired out, and aged. This boy was a young driver in the Brown Mine, driving pack animals for only 1 year, from 7 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. daily. The device attached to his cap is an oil wick cap lamp, which was lit when the boys were working in the mine tunnels. This little boy, George Ockertich, was a newsboy from St. Louis, Missouri. Lewis Hine captioned the photo to say, "Newsboy, little fatty, less than 40 inches high, 6 years old, been at it 1 year." However, he found out that the little boy was only 5 years old, meaning he started as a newsboy when he was only 4. The photo's composition is very well put together, with a tiny boy next to a big street lamp pole, arching his little back and sticking out his big stomach, while he's struggling to hold that many newspapers. Brings a very happy wow factor to the image. This photograph is one of my favorites because of the high contrast between little Giles Newsome and the dark house behind him, which relates to the dark story that he holds. At age 11, he worked in a cotton mill where a piece of machine fell on his foot, smashing his toe, which caused him to fall into a spinning machine, hand first, into unprotected gearing, which crushed and tore off two of his fingers. Sadly, he died at the age of 18 and had a poorly misspelled death certificate along with an unmarked grave. This photograph has a very pleasing design, with the stairs and railings leading up, but the little newsboy so tired that the stairs seem less intimidating and kind of comfortable. The photo gives off an unknown calmness, which is different from all the others. Lewis Hine's photographs greatly helped end child labor when the Children's Bureau was created. In 1938, the Fair Labor Standards Act fully brought child labor in the U.S. to an end.